everyone. So today I'm going to show you guys my full coverage foundation routine, and I do have quite a few foundation routines that I use because I work nights and I have the opportunity to make my makeup really fun, and I can wear bright colors and just change my foundation up whenever I want. And then I also have my daytime foundation routines as well, but this is just my plain and simple full coverage foundation routine that I use every night when I go to work. It is just like my tried and true long-lasting foundation that just stays put all night long. So I do have my glowy and dewy look that I will have coming up very soon, because a lot of you guys on Twitter have mentioned that you guys want to see that, and that is a beautiful foundation. So that one will be coming up very soon for you guys. But if you guys are interested in seeing how I do my full foundation routine and the products that I use, keep watching. Okay, so first things first, when you put your foundation on, you want to create a really nicely hydrated and moisturized canvas. So I go ahead and put my Timewise Mary Kay Firming Eye Cream on first. It looks like this. And I just put a little bit on with my ring fingers. And you always want to use your ring finger because that is the weakest finger on your hand when dabbing anything under your eyes or on your eyelids, because it's not going to create so much pressure and tug at your skin, and that's going to help prevent wrinkles. If you're using some sort of eye cream also, like I am using, try not to get it directly on your eyelids, because you don't want anything that's going to be very oily or moisturizing right up here when you're going to put makeup on. You can do that at night if you want to, but don't put it too close to the lash line either, because it could get into your eyes. But you don't want anything too oily that'll create creasing after you put your primer on. Then I'm going to moisturize my face with my Estee Lauder. This is the Day Wear Advanced Multi-Protection Antioxidant Lotion, and this has SPF 15. I was going back to using this one. I was using Radiance of Beauty for a while, and I loved that one. Or Stages of Beauty, I should say, with Radiance Cream, and that one was really good. I'm out of it, so I'm back to this one. I really like it a lot. I just dab it down the center of my face, and I'm pretty generous with my cheeks and my neck area. Reason being, I have dry skin. If you don't, you might want to find something that is suited to your needs if you have oily skin or combination skin. Then I go ahead and moisturize my lips, because I do want them to be very moisturized when I'm going to put my lipstick on, whether it be a bright color or a nude color. You always want your lips to look nice and hydrated, so this gives it the time to soak in the entire makeup application process. And I'm using Sugar Fresh, and this is just their clear balm. I actually got this from Sephora for my birthday gift, so as you can see, it looks like this. I really like it because it is extremely hydrating, and as soon as I blot it off before putting my lipstick on, my lips are so smooth. If you guys are wondering, this is my Mary Kay headband. I always wear it to push my hair out of my face because I have very long hair, so it gets all into my makeup. And I always wear an old t-shirt when doing my makeup as well, because it can tend to get, you know, fallout on it. If you're gonna wear the shirt that you're going out in and you get eyeshadow on it, you're totally like messed up for the night or for the day. So I always play it safe and wear an old shirt. So we're gonna go ahead and use a face primer next, and I've been using this one for a little while. This is the Almay Smart Shade Perfect and Correct Primer. This one kind of reminds me of the Stila primer, and I'm really enjoying it so far. What I will say is that you only need a small amount, because if you use too much of this, it's going to be quite tacky. So I use about a pea-sized amount, and it looks like that. And then I just mix it up and rub it all into my face. So after you've let your foundation, primer, and your moisturizer set into your skin, it's time to do the final step, which is your foundation. And this is the Estee Lauder Double Wear Stay in Place Makeup, and this is what I use for my full coverage look. This one is definitely full coverage, so if you're somebody who doesn't want something like that, be very careful of this. You cannot make this a super light coverage by any means. I've tried it with a beauty blender with water. This is a very, very heavy coverage. I like it because I tend to have a lot of redness in my face, and sometimes foundations will wear off during the day, and this one tends to stay put throughout my entire day and keep that redness at bay. So I just give mine a little shake. And I just pour a little bit onto the back of my hand. So this one does not have a pump, as you can see. You just need the tiniest bit. A little bit goes a long way. So if you just pour it on your hand like that and just have that much, you're good for your entire face. That might even be a little bit too much. For this process, I'm going to use my Estee Lauder foundation brush. I really like it a lot for applying this. And I always start on my forehead first. I go down the nose area, and then I go down to the cheeks and blend out into the jawbone. So that's just how I do it, because I have the most redness here and here. So as I'm blending down the center, I kind of blend out as well. And then I always do a double layer on my cheekbones because of the redness. At this point, you can definitely see the difference from the right side of my face to the left side. It's a lot redder on this side, and my right side is already covered up and looks like a nice blank canvas. Just going over those red spots on my cheeks, just with a little bit of extra foundation, and I just pat it down, and then I tend to go upwards like this just to blend it. I use a lot of different strokes when applying my foundation because you don't want any streaks. So if you go this way and then you go downwards, it kind of just tends to blend everything together a lot better than if you were just to go one direction with your foundation. It would look really streaky, especially with a full coverage foundation like this. Okay, now that that is done with, I have my full face of foundation on and my skin is a nice blank canvas for the rest of my makeup. I'm going to go ahead and contour, and I found this wonderful contour at the Dollar Tree, believe it or not. It is probably my all-time favorite that I've ever used. This is by LA Colors. It's only a dollar, and this is in the color tan, and this is like the most beautiful, non-shimmery, matte, beautiful contour for people that are pale like me. It doesn't look orangey, it doesn't look brown, it just looks natural and it just looks really beautiful. It's just a very soft contour and I just love it. And I'm using my MAC 168 brush, so I'm gonna use this to contour. I'm just gonna take this up the cheekbones just to kind of make my face look a little more chiseled. You want to make sure to blend your contour really well. And as you can see, this doesn't look orange at all. It just looks really natural, especially when I look to the front. You can see the difference from this side to this side, definitely. It makes my face look a lot slimmer. And that is the key to contouring. You want your face to look slimmer, angular, and a lot of people aren't sure what the concept of contouring is, but that's what it is. You put it into the hollows of your cheeks. So you want to put all your contours in the hollow areas of your face or places that you want to minimize. Like I usually do my forehead area, my nose, and I'll do my cheeks and jawbone. So we'll just keep going with the cheeks. So if you want to slim down your forehead, you can just do right here, right above your eyebrow area. Just blend lightly into the top of the forehead, right where the hairline is. Also keep in mind that I work nights, so contouring like this might not be necessary for an everyday look, but since I am working nights and I do work in night kind of lighting, this is very flattering for me. You can see already my face has a lot of different angles to it as we're looking at it just in the camera. But if you're going out at night or you're gonna go take pictures, you can contour your face like this. It'll look gorgeous. Now I do my jawbone because this makes your face look a lot slimmer. So if you wanna get rid of any double chin over here, you can just go ahead and do it that way. The key is to really brush a little bit of the color under. You don't want to do too much though, because you don't want to look like you didn't match your foundation to your neck. So it's just a lot of blending. And then the last part I'm going to do is my nose area. And I love to do this because it makes my highlight stand out a lot more. So I just do it down the sides of my nose and then along the tip. So you're going to leave the center area blank. You don't want any bronzing on there, because if you put bronzer on there, it makes your nose look whiter. So if that's something that you want, you could put a little bit of bronzer. I know a lot of people like to pop bronzer on their noses in the summer and in the springtime, but I prefer not to because it makes my nose look whiter and I just don't like it. It looks like, to me, when people do that, it looks like they ate too many oranges or sweet potatoes, or not oranges, carrots and sweet potatoes. I don't know if you've ever seen anybody that's eaten a lot of sweet potatoes or carrots. What is it, the carotene in it? Is that what it's called? It makes your skin kind of orange and it makes your nose and your palms of your hands orange. So I just prefer not to do that. So that's what I do to contour my face. As you can see, it's a lot more angular and this contour is just the bomb. I love it. Now I'm gonna go do my eye makeup and I'll come back and show you guys how I finish off with my concealer and my setting powder. Okay, so I'm back with my full face of makeup, and generally I would put my concealer on before I'd put my blush on, but just to save time for the tutorial, I'm gonna go ahead and just do it now so you guys can see. I'm gonna go ahead and use the Double Wear Stay in Place Flawless Wear Concealer with SPF 10. This is from Estee Lauder. I actually got this in a promotional gift, and I love, love, love this concealer. It has such a brightening effect under your eyes that it doesn't compare to any other concealer that I've ever used. So I just go ahead and swipe a little bit under the dark area right there and right here, and then I put a little bit under my nose because we tend to get a lot of redness in that area. So all I'm going to do is just take my ring finger once again and just pat this out, and I'm going to pat it out into this area as well to brighten it up and just bring the nose concealer up here as well, so everything just kind of blends together. For me personally, I really like to put my concealer on after I do my eye makeup because if there's any fallout, it can create dark shadows under here. So rather than do it right when I do all my foundation, I do it afterwards. And the reason I do it afterwards is because you want to put your foundation on first, and then if there's anything left that you need to go ahead and conceal, that's when you put your concealer on. I know a lot of people like to do their concealer first and then put their foundation on, but I kind of don't agree with that because you'll end up moving that concealer and it's not going to give you as much coverage as it would after your foundation. So apply your foundation and then do your concealer because it's gonna conceal anything else that you have left. Because if you do it first also, like for example, I would have concealed all my redness and I wouldn't have needed to do that. So my foundation covered that up, I was fine. So I only needed just a small amount. So the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation has a little bit of a dewy finish, as you can tell, and that's not something that I'm really going for. I kind of like to give it more of a satin look. I don't like a really matte face either, but I like to powder with the Organic Wear Physicians Formula Translucent Powder. I love this one. As you can see, I've already hit pan. This one gives you just a really beautiful finish to your skin. It makes it look really flawless. And I start on my forehead, and I just kind of swirl it on, and I bring it down to the center of my nose, down the center of my face, and then I'm gonna go under my eyes and then across my cheeks. So it doesn't matter if you have all your blushes on or anything like that, it's not gonna move it. It's translucent, so it's not gonna cover it up either. Now I'm gonna do a bit of highlighting on my face. So you guys saw that I contoured, and I'm gonna start off, this is the NYC Gold Radiance Blushable Cream Stick. And I love this one. This was actually a limited edition last summer, so I bought two of them. I just take my ring finger into this and I swipe it across my cheekbones, and I do it a little bit over my eyebrow area, so I kind of create just like a little C right here. I do that on both sides. And then I take it down the bridge of my nose and just right above my Cupid's bow. Now this one does have a little bit of shimmer, as you can see. It has shimmer in the stick, it's very gold, so if this is something that you don't like, you like more of a matte highlight, this would not be for you, but I really like the shimmery effect. Then I go ahead and set that with my, this is the Estee Lauder Shimmering Jewel Powder, and comes in a nice cute gold compact. This is something that has a little bit of shimmer. Again, I've hit pan, I love this, but if you're one that doesn't like a lot, this might be for you. But this just gives you like a little bit of a gold finish as well. So I just sweep that up here as well. And it really locks that blushable cream stick in place. Oh, and by the way, this is just a regular fan brush from Sephora that I've had for a really long time. So any fan brush will work. It works especially well down the bridge of your nose, so that's why I use it. It works to fit in all those small areas. And this is, again, a step that you may want to skip if you're going to work for the daytime or you're going out during the day. You don't need all of this highlight, but again, I am working at night, so this is what I wear. Now the last and final step that I do is a setting spray. I'm running out of this one, so I am taking suggestions for a new setting spray. This is the e.l.f. Makeup Mist and Set with Aloe Green Tea Cucumber and Vitamins A, C, and E. It looks like this. I have a tiny, tiny bit left, but so far so good. I really like it. The smell isn't my favorite, but I am, like I said, looking for a brand new one to try out. So I just give myself three mists, one on this side, one in the center, and one on the right. The reason I really like setting sprays is because if your face does look a little bit powdery, this will help to eliminate that powdery look, and it'll also keep your foundation and all your work that you put into your face lasting throughout the night or throughout the day. So I tend to make sure that I use my setting spray. It's something that is very hard to forget, but if you can try to remember, this one's only $3, so it's very affordable. So that was my full coverage foundation routine. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope it was helpful. If you guys have any questions, you can post them in the comment section down below. Better yet, if you guys have a full coverage foundation routine you'd like to share with me or with my viewers, you can post it as a video response and I'll be happy to accept it. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter and on Facebook, where I share a lot of daily news and pictures and bargain finds, and I will talk to you guys later. I love you. Bye.